Polynomial is from class 9 and now in which we define, and previously we define like the polynomial, types of polynomial, value of the polynomial, degree of the polynomials and zero of the polynomials. So these are the completed in the previous video, and now there are two topics remaining in this chapter, remainder theorem and factor theorem. So first, now there are two, in the next video we define the factor theorem, but in this video first here we, this is related with the theorem, so first here we state down statement, and then after statement we have to prove the remainder theorem. So first I want to explain here what you mean by the remainder theorem. Before of remainder theorem, first I want to explain you what you mean by the actual division. Actual division algorithm is defined here, and actual algorithm of division is defined by with the help of polynomials. So now we have to write down p of x, g of x, q of x and r of x, and we know that p of x, that is a polynomial, and now here polynomial means dividend, g of x also a polynomial but it is called divisor, and q of x resultant value, that is polynomial, also called here quotient, and now r of x is polynomial, that is remainder. Okay, and we know that this is the concept for verification of the any long division method, dividend equal to divisor to quotient plus remainder. We know that this formula. So by this formula we have verified like the your whole process in form of the polynomial. Okay, so first I want to explain you before remainder theorem, because remainder theorem and factor theorem, they are related with the division process. But division process, they are related with the polynomial. That is the concept of algebra. Okay, because not the numeric value you have to divide here, and resultant value also you have in numeric form. Your remainder also you have in numeric form. But only here we have the all p of x, q of x, g of x, p of x, r of x. All they are related with the algebra. So first here we define the algorithm, and now basically this algorithm based on the remainder theorem. So first now here we write down the statement for the remainder theorem. If a polynomial p of x is divided by g of x is the another polynomial, and now that is g of x is x minus a here, so remainder is p of a. It means now you have a particular polynomial like p of x, and now one particular term that is divided or divisor by something like x minus a, x minus b, any value are there, and then you find that value x minus a is here, and then you find the value of p of a, that is p of a is the remainder part. Okay, so where p of x is polynomial of degree greater than or equal to the maybe g of x, and a is any real number, and now we have to show that what do you mean by this remainder theorem. So p of x is a polynomial, and polynomial now here we call like dividend, and q of x and r of x are the quotient and the remainder, and now divisor is x minus a. Okay, now we can explain, because according to first any theorem, first we take the given part, and then how you use the given part in theorem. So first here we write down the basic need. Basic need is what? Dividend, divisor, quotient, remainder. Okay, and then how you apply, and basically we know that, because first basic part of this theorem is concept of division, because basically before of this I also explained about the algorithm of division. Okay, so here we write down same formula, dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So same concept here we put, because in place of dividend you put p of x, divisor that is x minus a, because here we write down, and now quotient that is q of x plus r of x. So either maybe your remainder is 0, because after division any part you divide it. So there are two options in remainder. Remainder may be 0, remainder not may be 0. So here we have two cases, either r of x 0 or r of x not equal to 0. So first case here we include like r of x equal to 0, then p of x equal to x minus a q of x, and now in place of r x you have 0. So write down here, on putting x equal to a, because your divisor is x minus a, so you put x equal to a, and then p of a, that is a minus a, and now q of a, so this whole part is 0, it means ultimately you have p of a equal to 0. So there is no remainder term after putting the value. If you first you put your divisor equal to 0, and then you got the value of in real numbers, and then you put in the whole polynomial, that is your remainder part. Okay, so it's 0 here, so whole part is 0. And now second case is r of x is not equal to 0. So x minus a q of x plus r of x you put as it is because it is not equal to 0. But on putting the same x equal to a, we have p of a equal to a minus a q of a plus r of a. So p of a equal to r of a. It means any value you substitute in place of p of a, you got the same value according to their concept. Like here we explain, p of x is divided by x plus a, suppose. Okay, so first you put x plus a equal to 0 by remainder theorem, and then x equal to minus a. So remainder is p of minus a, which is here. Okay, something is right down here. That is result of p of a. Now here you have x minus a. So this is the remainder. And now the same concept here we have, suppose, we take another example, p of x is divided by, suppose x minus 2, and then by remainder theorem first you put x minus 2 equal to 0, then you have x equal to 2, then remainder equal to p of 2. Okay, so any value you consider here, the same concept you apply. Your divisor value first you put equal to 0, and then that value you put in the polynomial, and after putting the polynomial you got the value of the polynomial. That value of polynomial is called the remainder. If that value is 0, then the case first you have, like r of x equal to 0. So there are two cases here we have. Maybe your remainder 0 or not, maybe your remainder 0, because not equal to 0 and equal to 0, there are two cases maybe arises. So first we take the example and then we illustrate this theorem. Okay, then we have example. In this example we find the remainder when p of x equal to 3x square minus 4x plus 12, and is divided by x minus 2, x plus 3 and x minus 1. There are three options here, like there are three examples, they are related with the same p of x. So first here we start the solution for our first part. Like first you have to take here, now divisor is x minus 2. Okay, so by remainder theorem, x minus 2 equal to 0, it means x equal to 2. So first here we have p of x, that is 3x square minus 4x plus 12. Okay, so you put here p of 2, and then 3 of 2 square minus 4 of 2 plus 12. So 3 into 4 minus 8 plus 12, and 3 4s are 12 minus 8 plus 4 are 12. Okay, so 24 minus 8, that is 16. Okay, so p of 2 is 16, it means remainder is 16. So we have remainder equal to 16. That is the first part over. Okay, because now here we divide by x minus 2. So if divide by x minus 2, then we have the remainder is 16. Okay, then now here we start second part. And second part, divisor is x plus 3. Okay, so by same concept we have here, by remainder theorem, so x plus 3, always you put remainder equal to 0, then x equal to minus 3. Now we write down the same here, p of x equal to 3x square minus 4x plus 12. So you put here p of minus 3, and now 3 of minus 3 whole square, 4 of minus 3 plus 12. So 3 into 9 plus 12 plus 12. 3 9s are 27 plus 24 here. So 51 is the answer. So remainder equal to 51. Okay, the concept is same. Only you putting the value of your divisor. First you your divisor equal to 0, and then you find the one real value, and that real value put in the polynomial, you got the answer of remainder. Okay, so now the last part, your divisor here like x minus 1. So by, again you put here by remainder theorem, x minus 1 equal to 0, so you have x equal to 1, and then you put p of 1 now directly here, so 1 square 4 into 1 plus 12, so 3 into 1 minus 4 plus 12, that is 3 minus 4 plus 12, 15 minus 4, that is 11, and 11 is related with the remainder. Okay, so we have 3 parts, and all parts that is the same question, you find the remainder. Okay, you find the remainder without division, that is from without division. Okay, so maybe your question like ask in the two ways. Okay, this question now here, same question we have, 3x square minus 4x plus 12, and is divided by x minus 2. Okay, so you verify your answer using the concept of remainder theorem or using the concept of actual division method. So now one example, they are related with the both actual division and remainder theorem, both we use, and in both the cases we have the same results. So now here we illustrate like same actual division and remainder theorem. Okay, in this example we have the same condition like previously, only that question we have find only the remainder by the concept of remainder theorem. But in this question, find the remainder when p of x, x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 5 is divided by x minus 2 by using remainder theorem and verify by actual division method. So there are two questions. One part, first you derivate, like find out with the help of remainder theorem directly. So there is no actual division concept. But also you divide the remainder, divide the your given polynomial with the given divisor and then find the remainder. So in both the cases you have the same result, or not you check or you verify your results. So first concept now can be applied. So first you write down the solution here, then first you write down actual dividend is p of x, that is x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 5, and we have g of x, that is the divisor, that is x minus 2. So by using remainder theorem, so g of x equal to 0, it means x minus 2 equal to 0, so x equal to 2. Okay, so this 2 you put in the given polynomial, and your given polynomial is, you have x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 5. Okay, so you put here p of 2, that is 2 cube minus 2 of 2 square plus 3 of 2 minus 5. So 8, again 8 plus 6 minus 5. So 8 cancel out, remainder is 1. Okay, so p of 2 you have, that is 1, it means remainder equal to 1. Okay, that is the final. Okay, now here the concept is nothing, only put the value, you got the direct remainder value. But in the actual division method, first you write down like the concept, first you draw. Okay, now divide, like the actual dividend is x cube minus 2x square plus 3 of x minus 5, and here you divide by like x minus 2. Okay, so first you write down your like every division concept, first you write down the rough work here, and divisor, your divisor you write down basically, first you write down here, and now first you require the first term of this actual division, like you have x cube, so by which variable expression you multiply outside here, and then you got first term as a x cube. So you multiply by x square, then x square into x, you have x cube, and then minus 2x square. So this resultant value, you write down here, x cube
minus 2x square. Okay, so and then change the sign. So after changing the sign, this is minus plus, and now this term is cancelled out. Both the terms are cancelled out. So you have x square here, and then secondly you add on like x minus 2 again, but the rest of the terms you bring down here, 3x minus 4. So basically now you are required here 3, because x is also in, so you have here. So multiply by this number only, so you multiply by 3 here, then you have 3x minus 6. Okay, so you write down here 3x and then minus 6. So after changing the sign minus and plus, of course term is cancelled out, remainder is 1. Okay, so you have remainder is 1, and now q of x is x square plus 3, and g of x, that is divisor, x minus 2, and now you have the division. Okay, so now here verify actual division method also, you have the remainder equal to 1, and using the concept of remainder theorem, you also have the value as a remainder 1. So in both the cases here verified, like your given question using the concept of remainder theorem, are you using the concept of actual division method. So in both the cases we have the same result, remainder r equal to 1. So now we have verified both the parts. Okay, so now one more confusion in this type of questions. Maybe your questions like this, one unknown term given in the dividend, and divisor is also given, this like divide by this, and now remainder is also given, and with the help of this remainder is given, then you find that unknown terms. So this this may be the another variety of, they are related with the same remainder theorem. So one example related with the unknown term in the dividend. Now in this example, first in this example given is if the polynomial p of x to the power 4 minus 2x cube plus 3x square minus 2ax plus 8 is divided by x minus 2, and it leaves a remainder 10, then find the value of a, because one unknown term is here, and then you find out using the concept of remainder. Okay, so because remainder we know that, so now here you don't use the concept of actual division method, you use the concept of remainder theorem. So using random solution, using remainder theorem, okay, so like g of x we have here like x minus 2, so that concept is g of x equal to 0, so x minus 2 equal to 0, so x equal to 2. Okay, and then p of x, which is x to the power 4 minus 2x cube plus 3x square minus 2ax plus 8. Okay, so putting the value of 2 here, p of 2, and then you have 2 to the power 4 minus 2 into 2 to the power 3 plus 3 into 2 square minus 2a of 2 plus 8. Okay, so p of 2, that is, we know that, that is given, that is 10, because there is also given part p of 2, you have 10. Okay, according to the concept of remainder theorem. So in place of p of 10, that is given 10, you write down here 16 minus, again 16, 4 3s are 12, minus 4a plus 8. So this 16 is cancelled out, 10, and now 12 plus 10 is 20, and minus 4a here, so 4a tends to here, and then 20 minus 10, so 4a equal to 10, and then a equal to 10 by 4, 2 5s are 2 2s are, so a equal to 5 by 2. Okay, so in this type of questions, if remainder is given, then you use the concept of remainder theorem, and putting the value, and after putting value you put the remainder part, because we know that using the concept of remainder theorem, your divisor is equal to 0, and then after putting the divisor you have the remainder. So you got the value of x equal to 2, it means p of 2, that is 10, that is a given. So now here we find out what is p of 2, because p of 2 you have one unknown term, so your p of 2 result in form of a. But we have to ultimately, we know that, so putting this value and then simplify
and then we find the unknown term here. Okay, so same variety, we have the another examples. Like in this example, we have two dividend, but they are divide the same divisor, and then after division, they have the leave the same remainder, and then find the again unknown term here. Okay, so like P1 of x, that is ax cube plus 3x square minus 3, and another P of 2 of x, that is 2x cube minus 5x plus a. Okay, so there are two dividend and one common divisor, that is g of x, which is x minus 4. Okay, and now given is P1 of 4 equal to P of 2 4, because we use the concept, like we use the concept of remainder theorem, because we know that R theorem, remainder theorem, we have g of x equal to 0, it means x minus 4 equal to 0, so you have x equal to 4. So directly you got the concept of like this, so therefore we write down P1 of 4 and P of 2 4, because after putting the value you got the same answer. And now what is given here, P of 4, and now these two are equal according to the condition, same, leave the same remainder on each of the case. Okay, so we find here like P of 1 first, P of 1 4, that is a into 4 cube plus 3 into 4 square minus 3. Okay, so 4 cube is 64, a, and then 16 3 is 48 minus 3. So 64a plus 45. Similarly, we find P24, that is 2 into 4 cube minus 5 into 4 plus a. Okay, so 64 2s are 128 minus 20 plus a. Okay, so you have 108 plus a. Now V1, which is P1 of 4, which is equal to P2 of 4, so 64A plus 45 and 108 plus A. Okay, so 64A, and now plus A here, so here minus A, and now 108 minus 45. Okay, so here very simple now, 63a, but here we have like 8 minus 5 is 3 and 10 minus 4 is 6. So again we have 63, so a equal to 63 upon 63. Okay, so cancel out, you got value of a equal to 1. Okay, so this is also very easy questions. In this question also we apply, because this is the another different category of the question, different variety of the questions, because we have the same meaning. Like in all the questions we do the same remainder theorem, the basic concept, because now here we conclude the whole topic, because first I revise it. Well, we start from the like remainder theorem. So first we define the concept of actual division method, and then we using the statement like what is the remainder theorem statement, and then how we prove remainder theorem in case of your remainder may be 0, not may be 0. So in both the cases we have find the value. Okay, and then some examples, like in first example we have a common dividend and then some different divisor are given there, and then using the concept of remainder theorem and then find the direct remainder. Okay, so in find direct the remainder, it means you put only your divisor, you equate with the 0, you got some real number from the divisor, and then that value you put in the dividend. Okay, and then dividend, it means the given polynomial, and now after putting the value you have some answer, and that answer is called the remainder. Okay, so that is the whole conclusion between the like all examples like here is that. So another variety may be question ask, may be asking in the examinations like actual division with the comparison with the remainder theorem, or maybe one unknown term is given and remainder is given. Okay, so find the unknown term with the help of given remainder. Okay, maybe like the last example here we listed, there are two dividend the polynomial and one common divisor divide by both the polynomial or both the dividend, and we leave the same remainder in both the cases and then find the unknown term. So maybe different variety are given there, maybe conditions like two dividend, two divisor differently given. Maybe remainder concept is given, like first dividend you have the different remainder, and then but their sum of remainder is like this much is given, then you find the unknown term. So maybe any other variety is given in the book. So first you do the concept like using the remainder theorem and find the given situations. Okay, so now I think you enjoy with the remainder theorem, because that is related from the 9th class, that is related with the polynomial chapters. So now you watching this video, thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, so please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel Sanjay Richoel.